If this is your first time using ArcCAD 28, but you want to look like a pro in your next class, this is exactly the video for you.
This is a beginner's introduction tutorial. So if you haven't used ArcCAD before, this might be a good refresher. Otherwise, it is intended for new users that want to show off a little bit with some advanced skills. So if this is the first time you're seeing the home screen, welcome. The first thing we want to do is come up to the top and select new. After that, you'll be prompted with a new project form. For me, I'm going to select the Australian select template and once again, hit new. Add a few seconds to load up and we'll see our home screen. To quickly run through the basics, on the left-hand side, we have our design and documentation palette. We will create all of our 2D and 3D objects. Up the top, we have all of our tools and toolbars, which we can adjust as we become more proficient. And on the right-hand side, we have our navigator. Generally, we want to be using the view map, and then when we're ready to put it onto pages, we want to go to our layout book. In ArcCAD 28, they've got this great little new feature to teach you how and what everything does. So if you're ever a little bit lost, simply run your mouse to whatever you're not certain of, hover over it, and it will show you exactly how to use that tool. So now that we've covered the basics, let's dive straight in. The first thing you want to do is go ahead and hit Control or Command 7. That's going to open up your story settings. We want to set our stories up based on our ceiling heights and our reference level. So for instance, here I'd like to insert a story below 172, and I'm going to call that footings. I'm going to replace the titles for everything that go ground floor, 27, ground ceiling. I like to use as my cavity space between two floors and the reflected ceiling plans. So in this instance, that might be 350mm, 345mm, it might be 600mm, whatever we need it to be. So I'll go 600 for the purpose of argument, repeat my first floor and create my roof layer as well. We can always go ahead and change these later. Setting these up at the start is going to help you link all of your walls and layers together. So this is why we do this first. Personally, I untick everything on the right here and then go ahead and click OK. So let's get started with creating some cool stuff. Straight away, we want to come up to the right hand side in our view map. I want to drop down my sketch plans and then I want to go to my ground floor presentation plan. You'll see it's set to 1 to 200 scale, which I personally don't like. I like it at 1 to 100. So I'll change it down the bottom to 1 to 100 scale. So everything is a little bit easier to read. You'll notice that you have a little warning in the bottom right hand corner here. That's basically a small little caution sign that's saying that if I was to double click on this again, it would automatically go back to 1 to 200 scale. So if we wanted to make sure that didn't happen, settings, change that to 1 to 100, press OK, and then every time we double click on that, it'll be 1 to 100 scale. What you see in front of you is your sections and elevation markers. We don't need any of those for this tutorial, so I'm typically going to left click once, press Control or Command D to activate Move Tool and move them out of the way. We're going to start by using our Slab Tool, and all we want to do is draw ourselves a simple rectangle. Let's go 20 meters, press the Tab button, Bonnet, 30 meters. To do that, all we have to do is start typing in some numbers. After that, we want to press Escape to get out of the Slab Tool itself, go to the Wall Tool, and up the top, you'll see we have a number of elements. These are all relatively advanced things, but the main one you want to focus on is the type of the wall itself. So by selecting this middle icon, we can double click into walls, and you should have a series of walls available to you. Depending on your template will depend on what you see here. It's not exactly necessary that you need everything I have. It's just what's the most common here in Australia. Let's jump down to the bottom and use this 90mm insulated stud plasterboard. So once we've selected up more, up the top left hand, just next to the wall type, we have our simple geometry. We're going to press and hold on this little arrow and go to the polygonal line tool. That way, when we start clicking, we can click and continue to draw all the way around to create our curved square. Now once again, hit escape. If we right click, go show wall in 3D, we'll see that we've already created a slab of four walls in 3D in a matter of seconds, which is the best part about ArcCAD. Now, if we select our walls, all of them will be grouped together. If we don't want that to happen, we want to press Option or Alt G for group, and that will activate or deactivate your grouping tool. So Alt G activates everything, Option G on Mac, once again, deactivates. Selecting more, we want to go in and open the settings. So Command T opens up all of the settings. Otherwise, on the top left-hand side, Next to our layers, we have our settings tool as well, which is the same icon as what you're selecting in the main toolbar. This seems very confronting and overwhelming, but there's only a number of things you have to look at the very start. First of all, are your walls linked to anything? If they are, where do you want them to be linked to? For instance, I can automatically link it to my first floor, and if I change that to 0 and press OK, all of those walls will jump straight up. I could repeat the same thing, drop it back down to the ground ceiling, and they'll drop it back down. So that is one of the main sections you want to look at when you're starting off in the wall selection settings. Next thing you want to look at is, of course, our graphic overrides. When people start in ArchiCAD, they want to know how to make their models look pretty, they want to know how to render, and these are the two ways to do it. We simply click the graphic override, which is the easiest way without creating multiple scenarios of the same wall, and then go ahead and select a different wall finish. So there's a number of different pre-made textures in ArchiCAD that you're able to go through. If I was to double click on metal, I could go and select the stainless steel metal, for example, on the outside, press OK, and all my walls would change to stainless steel. If I wanted them to be black, I could type in black. Let's go paint black ivory. And there we go, we have black painted ivory. If I press Control or Command Z, I can go back and undo anything. Alternatively, up top, you have your back and forward arrows as well. Now, just like the wall tools, we have our slab tool settings available to us with Command T. Opening that up tells us exactly where it is and what's going on. So the home story is currently the ground floor, but actually it should be the footings. If you're ever changing the home story, just take note of the reference to project zero number here. As soon as I change that to footings, that will also change, but I don't want the position to change. The zero, press OK, and that slab is now up on the layout and on the right level. So back in our ground floor, we can't click on that slab at all, but if we go to footings, double click on the right hand side, we'll see our footings. We can double click or we can go up and down with our arrow keys on our keyboard by holding the Command or Control button, and by pressing Command and up arrow twice, we'll jump two layers. Pressing the down arrow will jump another layer as well. If we wanted to start adding doors and windows, this gets really easy in ArchiCAD. Simply come across, hit the door tool, and we can either try and drag and drop our first door in straight away by hovering over any wall. We'll see our reference line come up based on the reference to the exterior of that wall. If we wanted it to be exactly, let's say, a meter away, we can hit the tab button and type in 1 meter. And our door will go in. Now we have our door in place, we go in 3D, we'll see that door's been created. Fantastic, we've done something very easy, very quick. But what if we don't like that door? What if we don't want that door? Well, just like everything else, we press the Command T button and we open up our door selection settings. This menu is a little bit more involved because it's an object rather than a simple wall or a slab. On the left-hand side, you'll see a number of options. Of course, we have our basic library loaded with ArchiCAD, and we have a series of different doors, hinged, rotating, sliding, and storefront. And if I scroll through any of them, we'll see a number of different options available to us. Now let's say I want this door with a sign light on side 2. I can select that door, it would automatically change, and then I can go through it and play with all my settings. Let's say I want it to be a glass door, the handle, I wanted it to look like handle number 1, and then I can work my way through the settings, find out everything else that I needed to. It is all very, very self-explanatory. It does take you a little bit of time to get used to these settings, but once you know, they're super easy to go through. We can go to our 3D option view to see how that door looks, and we can also go to our front view to see how it looks in elevation. Now, the orange lines are hideous. We can, of course, go to our drop-down menu, come to floor plan and section, and then change all of these line types as we see fit. Or we can override the pen with one click and change it to a black. Now, both in floor plan and in elevation, it'll be 100% black. Similarly, we can come to our door leaf category, model attributes, uniform the door surfaces, and change everything to monument. We have to repeat that step for our fixings and fixtures as well. And there we go. Now we have a black door. I press enter, you'll see that has changed in 3D. Now, if you're wondering why this door looks a little bit basic and it isn't showing you what it did show in those settings up top, that's because our 3D window isn't set up the way we want it to be. We have come out of a sketch and marketing presentation plan, and that's of course using our sketch and marketing settings. Down the bottom here, you'll see sketch and marketing. which is in the model view options. If we simply select that and change it to construction, we'll see the level of detail significantly increases on that door. Now, if we come back to our ground floor plan, obviously a 20 by 30 meter rectangle box is absolutely massive. So let's say we want to reduce it. We can simply select all of our walls, make sure we've suspended our groups with Alt G, click on one of the external blue lines. By clicking on that blue line, we'll open up our first pet palette. It's called a pet palette because it basically follows you around wherever you go. You can change that in the settings if you wish. I personally fixed it in a single location. What we're going to be exploring is the offset edge tool right now. So by selecting the offset edge, we can drag that edge all the way in. Let's type in 10 meters and repeat the same process on the top edge. Let's say 15 meters. And all of a sudden our project got significantly smaller. But what you notice is we didn't decrease our footings in one go, and we have no idea where our walls are. In this scenario, it was relatively simple, 10 and 15 meters. But in most other scenarios, it's better to right click on the layer you're looking for and show as trace reference. Now we'll see those walls above us shown as a trace, and we can simply drag and snap to those edges in a matter of seconds. By default on my ArchiCAD, it doesn't show you how to turn off this trace reference. So if you have the same issue, we come up to Window, down to Palettes and Trace Reference. And we can drag and drop it directly into our toolbar. And to turn it off, we simply hit the two trace reference squares up the top, and it's all done. The trace reference is gone. We can toggle that on and off as much as we need.
What's going on, team? My name's David Tomich. I'm a registered architect here in Western Australia. And if it's your first time here, thank you so much for joining me. I just want to take a quick little pause in this tutorial to let you know that down in the description is davidtomich.com.au. If you jump down there right now, you'll be able to grab your ArchiCAD shortcuts completely free, as well as a variety of other great architectural resources for architects, students, or anybody in the field. But that's enough of me. Let's get back to the tutorial.
The process is near identical for windows. We simply select the window tool on the left-hand toolbar, drop it into the project, hit the escape button, and we'll see it's already built in 3D. We can move this window in 2D and in 3D. So by selecting one of the black hotspot nodes, you'll see that we can move our window left to right, or we can elevate it up and down. And at the same time, if we hit that black spot, we can adjust the size of the window as wide as we like and as tall as we like by simply following the pet palette information we have available to us. If we don't like and look at that window exactly the same as the door, we go in to our main window settings. We find what is available to us. Let's say a double sash window. We can go through those settings, adjust the pens, adjust the materials. It is all the same. So what we need to do to be able to replicate is very, very easy once we learn the fundamental basics of one object, for instance, the door. Speaking of objects, we have our little chair tool over here. If we hit the chair tool, unlike doors and windows, we don't want to just go ahead and click for the first time. We actually want to open up our settings because that way we can see what object we're dropping in. ArchiCAD has a relatively good library by default available to it. If we're looking for something like a toilet, you can type in toilet and it will show you a number of different options, from a disabled to a corner to a standard water closet. Just like the doors or the windows, most of the settings here are pictographical. So if we want to change the bolt type, we can go to type 6. If we want to change the cistern in wall, we can go ahead and do that. Then it changes to a push button plate. Let's say we like type 4, and maybe we don't want to have the seat on top. Maybe we do, maybe we don't want the lid. We can customize and play with all of these options very simply. The one thing I haven't touched on yet is, of course, our layers. ArchiCAD treats layers the same as Photoshop. By setting up our layers, we can define what is visible to a particular plan and what is not visible. So for instance, this toilet has been defined as objects general. If we select that layer, you'll see we have a number of different layers predefined. Now for me, this should go into objects, sanitary ware and fittings, alternatively go into MEP plumbing, but this is a relatively basic one and you'll see that the eye is turned on. So by default, you will see it on this page. So let's select the correct layer, press OK, and drag and drop our toilet somewhere into the project. If you don't hit the escape button on your keyboard, you can keep dropping as many toilets in as you see fit. Obviously, we don't want that many. So click once, select all, delete, and we have one toilet left. If we wanted to rotate this toilet and drag it somewhere else, we can either select on the node, hit the drowning tool, and then come across, or of course we could press Command D, select anywhere in the toilet, and then move it freely. Similarly, if we want to rotate it, hit the node, come across to our rotate tool, click on one node, click on the second, and rotate round to where we want the toilet to be. I personally advise everybody to learn to hold shift whenever they're moving things, rotating things, or doing anything. That way you'll always snap to a certain degree. Rather than be at 91.72, for instance, we could always make sure it's at 90. If you get bored of that hotspot command, you can simply press Command or Control E, and that opens up your rotate tool. E, I don't know why, it should be R, but in ArchiCAD, it is E. You'll see here the external wall is on our external layer. If we were to hold the Option button and click on the external wall, it will duplicate those settings. So then we can go ahead and draw another wall on the inside, defining our spaces. Double click to finish at the end and escape, of course. Now, all of those walls are on the external walls layer, and we want to make sure they're on the internal walls layer, which is absolutely critical. Because when we look at our site plan, we don't want to see our external walls, we just want to see our external walls. Whereas when we look at our ground floor plan, we want to see everything. Now, we can repeat the same process for our first floor by going up one level, drawing in a slab, going up another level, and drawing in the walls. Or we can copy everything by selecting everything, going Command or Control C, pressing Command up, up, and then Command V paste. Now, that was relatively quick, so I will repeat that. We go to our ground floor plan, and we click once, select everything. We can either right-click, copy, or we can use the keyboard shortcut, Command Copy. Double-click on the floor plan above. Just for argument's sake, I'm going to show the ground floor as a trace reference. And then we can right-click, and we can paste, or we can press Command V. Whenever we paste anything on ArchiCAD, you'll see the fine moving dashed line. That means it's dropped in, but it isn't confirmed. You have to click outside of that box for it to be confirmed and drop in. Now on the second floor, obviously we don't want a door floating, but we do want everything else. So as you will see, we have our second story completely copied above. We can delete that window, select all our walls, open the settings, but make sure your upper floor is also linked to roof and the offset is zero. So that way when we press OK, it'll just drop the bottom and we have one large ugly box. Now, of course, all architecture is one large ugly box until we as architects start actually designing something from interiors to exteriors, considering natural light, solar passive design, and ventilation. But the beginning concept of how to use ArchiCAD is very, very much the same.
Anyway, that's all for me, team. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you smash that subscribe button down below. And like always, I'll see you next week.